Achieving gender equity is one of the great social, political, and economic challenges of our time. Harmful stereotypes and assumptions about girls and women are being shattered daily. But what is the place of boys and men in the post-Me Too world? With a skillful mix of original reporting, scholarly research, and personal anecdotes, Rachel Gisa presents a deeply felt examination of the forces that shape how boys see themselves and how we see them. No one, from parents to policymakers, can read boys without rethinking their notion of manliness, masculinity, and how we raise young men.
I spent a lot of my journalism career writing about feminism and women's issues. And then my wife and I had a son. And so I suddenly found myself raising a boy and wondering about the rules for boys and men and wondering about masculinity.
We're in an era where we're talking about, you know, the Me Too era, time's up, a lot of women calling men to account. And this is kind of the other side of the coin. How are boys going to change? How are men going to change in this brave new world?
This is going to be, and is going to continue to be, a huge challenge for policymakers, educators, parents. And here is a book that, you know, while it is, you know, can't possibly be definitive, it really gives you a way of beginning to think about how it is that we create the kinds of men that we create in the society and what we could maybe do differently.
I think this can shape the way that we think, the way that we're not shaming and blaming, but the way that we're taking an issue that is very sensitive, very complex, and we're looking at it in this very vulnerable way. We're looking at it from the eyes of a young boy.
I want my son to know that there's no one right way to be a man. And I want him to be skeptical anytime he hears a person based on some aspect of their identity must be this way or must be that way.
This is one of the most important things we can do as a society, is shape healthy young men. And we don't do a very good job of it.